Hello, Tech World. This is Tech Thoughts, and welcome to this special Tech Thoughts video series focused on learning PowerShell. This is an operationally designed video series which aims to get you ramped up and using PowerShell quickly. This is video 4 in the series, getting set up for PowerShell development. As always, if you prefer written documentation, the corresponding article for this topic can be found on the techthoughts.info blog, which I've linked in the description below. So for the longest time, when people were developing PowerShell scripts or writing PowerShell functions or modules, they used the Windows PowerShell Integrated Scripting Environment, or the PowerShell ISE. This was the native PowerShell editor that shipped with Windows, and it's a solid little editor, and it's done some great things for a lot of people for a really long time. Moving forward, the ISE is no longer getting any type of support or features updates. It does not support anything higher than PowerShell 5.1, so you won't be able to develop for 6 or higher versions of PowerShell. The ISE also doesn't run on Linux or macOS. So while you might have the ISE if you're running on Windows today, it's not the right editor for you moving forward. Instead, the majority of people in the PowerShell community are developing on Visual Studio Code. VS Code is a modern editor. It supports a lot of advanced features. It has a lot of extensions. It's highly customizable, and it runs on Windows, Linux, and macOS. So regardless of which platform you're on, you'll be able to easily write PowerShell. Simply visit code.visualstudio.com/download and download the appropriate version that you need. Once you've got Visual Studio installed, you can go ahead and fire it up. So Visual Studio Code does not natively support PowerShell development, and let me show you what I mean by that. So if I open up a new file, and I used Control N to do that, or you could do File and then New File, you'll notice that this defaults to plain text. And even if I click on this and change the file type I'm working with, notice that VS Code supports many different languages. Even if I come down to PowerShell, if I type in known commandlets, you'll notice that I don't get any syntax highlighting. I don't have any tab completion. It doesn't show me what parameters are available. It's not really doing a whole lot for me. And in modern editors are capable of doing a lot more, but we have to do some settings in Visual Studio Code to get it working nicely with PowerShell. So the first thing we're going to be doing is installing the PowerShell extension. So Visual Studio Code does support hundreds and thousands of extensions. And you can get to those by coming over here on the left side and clicking the Extensions tab. Once you're in the Extensions tab, you can simply search for PowerShell. And the first result that we have here is the PowerShell extension released by Microsoft. It's as simple as clicking the Install button here. And notice, and this may differ depending on which operating your system on, that it went ahead and kind of set our color scheme to the PowerShell ISE. So if you are familiar with the ISE and are gonna feel like you're missing a lot on that, you can make Visual Studio Code look exactly like the ISE. I prefer the dark theme, so I'm gonna stick with that. I'm going to close the extension tab by clicking extensions again, and I'm gonna close this extension window. Notice now that as I start typing git service, that the editor is already behaving much differently. I'm getting some suggestions about which commandlets I might be wanting to type in. And if I click tab, I'm getting that nice tab completion showing the git service commandlet that I want to type inside the editor. Additionally, now that I have the PowerShell extension, I can start running some of this code inside of the terminal window that you see located down here inside Visual Studio Code. So I can leave my cursor on this line and I can right click and I can run the selection, which will execute just this particular line. So if I run that now, this will get the services on this device and display out running PowerShell inside of this terminal window. If I want to run multiple lines of code, I can do git service name bits. And if I want to run both lines, I simply highlight both and I could right click and run selection, or you'll notice that there's a shortcut for F8, which allows me to quickly run that code inside the terminal window down here. So it runs the first command, git service, and then we'll run the subsequent command, git service bits, showing us that that service is indeed stopped on this particular device. To provide an even more streamlined PowerShell development experience, we're also going to need to adjust some of Visual Studio Code's settings. Now, in order to do that, first I'm going to go ahead and stash the terminal window away. And the easiest way to do that is Control Tilde. That's typically the keyboard key that's directly under your escape key or around that area, usually next to the one, if you're not familiar with the tilde key. So Control Tilde will bring the terminal window up really quickly, or it'll stash it away, getting it out of your way. And so now that I've got that cleared out, I'm going to go ahead and open up Visual Studio Code's settings menu. The easiest way to do that is Control Comma. Get used to shortcuts with Visual Studio Code. There's lots of them. They'll make you very fast. Now, this will go ahead with Control Comma, pop up the Visual Studio Code graphical settings interface. Now, you can search for things inside of here. So, for example, change the font. I'm going to make a recommendation, though, that you try not to use the GUI-based editor inside Visual Studio Code. A lot of examples online are going to actually show you JSON settings, and I'm going to show you how to kind of work with that now. So you'll notice if we come up to this upper right-hand corner up here in the settings menu, there's an Open Settings JSON button. And if we click that, you'll notice that the only setting that we currently have in here is the terminal integrated font size is 16. Which is the graphical change that we just made a moment ago. It went ahead and populated that in here. As you search for various settings or how to configure VS Code, a lot of times you're going to see people provide the JSON of this instead of where to set it inside of the GUI. So it's good to get familiar with this. If you're not familiar with JSON, don't be intimidated by adjusting settings in this way. JSON is very easy to work with and read, and it does make a certain amount of logical sense to adjust the settings of your code editor with code. On the techthoughts.info blog, I've given you a basic setup for PowerShell development. You can go ahead and visit the blog post and easily copy this particular JSON example and simply paste that into your editor. Click save, and those settings will immediately take effect. I'd like to spend a few minutes just going over some of these very basic settings. This is a timing delay for how quickly the quick suggestions will be displayed. You can adjust this time to suit your needs. I do like tab completion to be on, so I have that set. And I like it when I click a new file that it goes ahead and opens up in PowerShell. If you use Visual Studio Code to develop with other languages, you may want to comment out this particular setting. Let me demo it for you. If you do Control N with this setting applied, notice that this file has the PowerShell icon up here. And if we look down here, it has defaulted to PowerShell. Without that setting in place, it would open up as a normal plain text file. Before we get into this section right here, I'm going to go ahead and talk about some of these down here real fast. So in this section, we can set up things like the PowerShell coding style. Stay tuned for additional videos for more on that. We can determine if we would like PowerShell to start automatically when VS Code is launched. Do we want to do script analysis? I'll show you that in just a moment. And do we want to show the integrated console on startup? So these are just little settings to kind of make your development experience a little bit better. Now let's come up to this section, a very important one. If you're not sure what settings do, you can always highlight over them in the settings.json file, and they will explain exactly what they're configuring. So this path of the shell is determining where the actual PowerShell executable is. And if you're developing on Windows, this is very important for you, because if you want to write for PowerShell 6, you'll need in JSON format to give the exact path to the PWSH, which is PowerShell 6 on Windows. If instead you would prefer to develop for 5.1 or lower versions, you're going to need to comment that stuff out and instead uncomment the PowerShell.exe version and click save. Notice that this indicates down here that the PowerShell runtime has changed, and would I like to start a new session? So if I bring up the console window real quick and I type in PS version table, and let me go ahead and actually adjust this font so that we can see a little bit better. And I will do that with editor font size, and I can just change this to 16, click save, and immediately the font size will change. Getting back to the console window, if I type in PS version table, since this is a Windows device and I have this going to PowerShell.exe, we are developing for 5.1. If instead I would prefer to develop for PowerShell 6 or higher, I can simply comment out these lines, uncomment the PowerShell 6, click save, restart the terminal window. And you can now see that the PS version table is set to 6.2.1. If instead you are running on a Linux device or a Mac OS device, you'll need to determine the path, comment out the Windows locations in the example if you use the one off the techthoughts.info blog, and instead specify the path for your particular distro here. So this is a basic settings.json to get you started coding PowerShell using VS Code. For me personally, I have quite a bit more settings than this, and I can go ahead and easily paste those in there. and get my VS Code console exactly the way that I prefer it, simply by pasting in those settings and clicking save. Notice now that the color of the syntax changes. I prefer a brighter syntax color and things of that nature. So again, VS Code is highly customizable. You can install lots of extensions, and with those extensions, you can configure very easy settings inside of the JSON. Just the name of the setting, colon, the setting itself, and comma for the next line. Nothing to it, and if you have questions, please post them in the comments below. I'll be happy to address them. Okay, so now that we've got the settings configured and we've got the PowerShell extension installed, I want to show you a little bit about how VS Code can parse the code that we're going to write. I'm going to go ahead and type in this function real quick. You'll notice immediately that I see some squiggly lines here that kind of are showing me that there might be some problems with this particular code set. If you're not sure what the function does, don't worry. Stay tuned for additional TechThoughts PowerShell videos. We'll be covering functions in great detail. So notice that if I put my cursor over this particular query-demo, the PS script analyzer, or the PowerShell script analyzer, is letting me know that this is not an approved verb. Did you know that PowerShell has a list of approved verbs? And if we come over to this article on Microsoft, you can find an entire list of PowerShell approved verbs, like close, copy, enter, exit. Query is not an approved verb, and it's violating one of the rules. Now, in your VS Code, you may not be seeing this if you go ahead and type this into your console. And that's because VS Code does not natively have the capability to parse the code like this. This functionality is being provided by the PS Script Analyzer module. If you don't already have that installed on your system, you can go ahead and install it from the PowerShell gallery by typing in install-module PS Script Analyzer and clicking enter. If you've never installed the module from a gallery before, it'll ask you if you trust the PS gallery. Go ahead and click yes, and this will enable VS Code to parse your code as you're starting to write it. Windows users, don't forget that if you're going to be developing for both, you need to have the PS Script Analyzer installed both in the 5.1 and in 6. So make sure that on Windows that you also launch a run as administrator PowerShell window on that side and run the exact same command, install-module PS Script Analyzer. You can see here on my system that I already have it installed on the 5.1 side as well. I confirmed that by running git-module PS Script Analyzer, listing all available modules that match that name. Okay, so with PS Script Analyzer installed, again, you're gonna be getting that great insight into if your code is violating any common best practices. Notice again that GCI is also squigglied, and that's because this is an alias of git-child-item. Git-child-item is a commandlet for interacting with stuff on the file system. And GCI and git-child-item do the exact same thing. But as a best practice, you shouldn't use the alias. So if you were to share this script with someone, they may not understand what this code does, whereas git-child-item is much more clear. Okay, so at this point, with the PowerShell extension installed, with PS Script Analyzer installed, and with a few minor PowerShell settings set in our settings.json file, you're ready to start writing PowerShell code using Visual Studio Code. Before we close out, it's worth spending a little bit of time getting to know VS Code a little bit better. Let's go ahead and get some of these closed out. And I'm quickly closing those just by clicking the middle mouse button to close these particular windows. It'll ask me if I want to save this one. I do not. So we're going to be spending quite a bit of time using VS Code moving forward, and that can be a much more enjoyable experience if you're using a color scheme that's easy on your eyes. So in order to change the theme that Visual Studio Code is using, we need to interact with the command palette. The command palette can be displayed as you see here on the screen with Control-Shift-P. If you're on Linux or macOS, your shortcut might be slightly different. I'm going to go ahead and stash the terminal window again by clicking Control-Tilde, and I'm going to open the command palette with Control-Shift-P. There are many different commands that you can run here that will cause a variety of actions to happen within VS Code, but we'll start off with just adjusting the color scheme. So I'll simply type in color here, and notice that one of the things that comes up is Preferences Color Theme, and I'll go ahead and select it. This opens up another menu, and notice that we have a couple of themes to choose from. So again, if you prefer the PowerShell ISE look, you can get that. And Control-Tilde to bring up our editor. Notice that this looks and feels a whole lot like the PowerShell ISE that used to ship with Windows. Again, Control-Shift-P, bringing up that command palette, color theme. And instead, we can check out something like Dracula color theme. If you can't find a color scheme that works for you, there are many, many to choose from in the extensions menu. Simply search around in here until you find one that works for you. So now let's talk about working with different file types. Now, based on the settings that we adjusted a moment ago, whenever we control N and launch a new file, that's going to default to PowerShell. And note down here that we see that PowerShell is the selected language. And because of the settings we also did working with 6 and showing it where the PWSH exe was, we're defaulting to 6.2. So it shows you exactly what version of PowerShell that you're running down here. But let's say we wanted to work with a JSON file or a markdown file instead of PowerShell. Select here. And then if we wanted to work with markdown, we could simply select markdown. And now we could be working with writing inside markdown. So we could do TechThoughts, Learn PowerShell. And again, Visual Studio is very dynamic and versatile. And so we can even do a preview and see our markdown here inside of the console, episode 1, PowerShell basics, so on and so forth. Go ahead and close that preview. And if we wanted instead to work with JSON, again, you can come down here, select the language, find JSON. The shortcut for this is Control K and then M. And then we could switch to JSON or JSON with comments. And we can start writing inside JSON. So you can work with whatever file type that you want using VS Code, and that's how to switch between different various file types. We're going to be using VS Code for the remainder of the TechThoughts PowerShell video series. If you didn't get a chance to follow along in this particular video, I highly recommend that you watch it again when you get back to your computer and make sure that you're set up so that you can use VS Code for PowerShell development moving forward. Remember that all of this information is available in written format on the techthoughts.info blog. If this video helped you out, go ahead and click that like button and subscribe for more TechThoughts videos.